Welcome to a short presentation about how to use the Symbolic execution debugger to inspect proof attempts. What you can see here is the current Eclipse Mars release in which all extensions that are offered by the key project are installed. First, have a look at method add. The method should create a new array containing the content of the original one followed by the new content provided as argument. The Java modeling language JML is used to specify this intended behavior. The advantage of doing so is that we can now prove that the implementation fulfilled the specification. If not, there is potentially a defect in the source code or its specifications. As the method contains a loop, we need a loop invariant in addition to the method contract. To start the verification process and to automatically keep track of all verification proofs, I will use an Eclipse extension called KeyResources. All I have to do is to convert the current Java project into a key project. The conversion also starts the verification of the whole project and tries to verify that all JML specifications are respected by the source code. When you look now at the source code, you can see this warning marker. It indicates that the verification of the method did not succeed. But why? To find out the reason, we have to inspect the proof attempt. For instance, we can use a quick fix to open the proof attempt in the Symbolic execution debugger. The Symbolic execution tree shows the full program behavior explored by the proof. A proof is successful if and only if each branch ends in a termination node and if none of the nodes is marked as not verified, indicated by a red crossed out icon. Here, the loop invariant is marked as not verified. This means it doesn't hold initially. To identify the unproven subformula, we can trace the true statuses evaluated by the proof. This is done in properties tab loop invariant. It shows, for each open goal, the proof obligation to verify on the right side after the secant error. In addition, the left side shows additional constraints under which the proof obligation is evaluated. Here, the formula saying that I is less than the length of the array does not hold because the pink color says it evaluates to false. At first, that might come as a surprise, but it is true in case the array is empty. So let me correct the invariant by changing it to less or equal. When I save the file now, the prover is triggered again and tries to redo the proof. And it seems that this was not the only defect, so we have to inspect it again. This time, we can see that the termination node is marked as not verified. This means that the post condition could not be proven to hold. Again, the true status tracing helps us to identify unproven subformulas. Here, one part of the post condition and the assignable clause were not completely evaluated by the proof because they are colored in gray. Just by looking at the source code, it is obvious that the method does not change any existing location. Most likely, the prover struggled with the post condition and never tried to verify the assignable clause. But why does the prover fail to verify the post condition? To answer this question, we can inspect, for instance, the final state shown in few variables. The value at index i_0 is representative for an arbitrary loop iteration. Additional constraints are shown in the properties tab constraints. Here, no constraint about that value exists, so we can conclude that the loop invariant is too weak. Let me fix it by specifying in addition that for all integers j, where j is greater or equal to 0 and j is less than I, the value in the result array is identical to the value in the original array. After saving the file now, the warning marker will hopefully change into information marker telling us that the verification was successful. So we can be sure now that the implementation adheres to its specification. In this example, we used the prover in an autoactive flavor. This means we inspected a failed prover attempt, identified the reason, and corrected it by adjusting code or specifications. As you have seen, the Symbolic execution debugger is a powerful assistant to inspect proof attempts. It allows you to inspect the program behavior explored by the proof and to identify unproven subformulas, which helps to identify the reason why a proof remains open. Thank you for your attention.